We are in Canastota, New York, the home of the Boxing Hall of Fame. Canastota is a village located in the town of Lenox, and it's in Madison County, about 5 hours from New York City. And it's a small little village, so let's check it out. Right now I'm standing in front of this little location. If you follow boxing, Carmen Basilo, born here in April of 1927. He's the son of Joe and Mary Basilo, Hall of Fame boxer. World champion back in the 50s. So this is where he was born, which is a block away from a big attraction here as far as Canastota goes. The Greystone Castle. We'll go check it out. Quaint little neighborhood here. So let's check out the Greystone Castle. So this is the holy mecca. This town is the holy mecca for boxing. The Hall of Fame, just like Cooperstown, is known for the Baseball Hall of Fame. Check out this castle. Four stars and stripes, may freedom forever fly. Let it ring. This must be the original bell here. Can we look down? Oh, nope, not much to see. But here's the main tower. It was built. Oh, it used to be a church from 1833 to 1909. Wow. I know it's closed, but this is placed on the National Registry of Historical Places. Yeah, very nice. Greystone Castle, built in 1909. The glass stained windows, pretty cool. All right, let's see what else we can find in Canastota, New York. All right, so we're gonna go downtown, check out the sights of Canastota, which is located on the Erie Canal. There's a little bar over here, it's cold. I'm not sure, no name. But this town was established back in 1825, I do believe. Another place that seems to be out of business. I'm on the corner of Canal Street. There's a... Let's cross this way. So here we got the Erie Canal running through this part here. Looks like it's closed off. Says the Erie Canal encouraged settlers to establish farms and helped small upstate towns become economically viable. Canastota, founded in the early 1800s, had an agricultural economy based on products like onions and celery. But in 1870s, the town experienced a burst of industrial growth. The Canastota Knife Company was established in 1874 and Gaudi Knitting in 1875. In 1876, Baird's Steam Mill opened, and in 1880, Lindley Boats, the Canastota Glass Works, began in 1881. Hubert Canning in 1882, and 1893 saw the opening of Watson's Wagons. So yes, lots of history in this small little town. But let's see what it's like in 2021. Community Bank. What's this over here? We got the Postal Service. Let's cross. Just looks like there's a little more going on across the street. The Bee Man. So it's a candle company. So the candle company is called the Bee Man Candle Company. Homemade candles. How often do you see that? Okay. Site of Bruce Opera House from 1888 to 1909. Very cool. Used to be an opera house if anyone listens to opera. Tattoo shop. Ooh, a brewing company. Very cool. Didn't see that coming. Very nice. And we got, what is this? Mexican restaurant. It's called La Bamba Mexican restaurant. We're gonna keep on cruising. What is this here? Lois Adamo. Police chief killed at this location while directing traffic. Look at that. What's down here? Looks like a baking company. Center Street Market. All right. We're gonna head back to the main strip. Am I gonna try a slice of the Canastota pizza here? It's called New York Pizzeria. I gotta give it a try. Gotta grab a slice. Let's do it. All right, so I ordered some pizza. They don't do slices, so I grabbed a small pie, and we'll do a taste test. In the meantime, we're gonna keep on trucking. Nail salon. Canastota Bridge. Any of you investors out there, what do you guys think of the whole cryptocurrency market? Little disappointed with the Dogecoin and Elon Musk. I thought he was gonna give us a nice push for all you Dogecoin investors out there, but all the cryptos took a huge hit this week. Look at this cool skate park. Let's check it out. I used to skate back in the day, a lifetime ago. Just a random skate park in the middle of the village. What is this? Welcome to Lenox Canastota Wantville Rail Trail. All right. But I like this skate park. It's pretty cool.
How you doing?
Hey, man. Dude's taking his bike out for a nice little stroll, nice little ride. Wow, this is pretty decent size. Nice, very nice. Yep, cool little skate park. Let's head back. See, I think that's the new Tesla, the Canastota Tesla company. Let's check it out. Very cool. Self-driving vehicle. Actually, it's the Watson wagon. The Watson wagon, Canastota, New York. One of the businesses they mentioned, the Watson Wagon Company. There you go. Not sure, was this a motorized thing? Nope, probably horse powered. Watson Wagon Company. Cool, 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 cool. Check out some of the McMansions here, Victorians, 100-year-old houses. Check this one out. Being renovated as we speak. I think they're painting it pink. This one across the street. Sun is setting. Beautiful day though. Feels like it's 85. How many bedrooms you figure that bad boy is? I'd say about 25. No, I'm kidding, but it's a big house. There's another one. That used to be a carriage house, I do believe. Church over here, First Baptist Church. So yeah, they do host a parade, a boxing Hall of Fame parade here annually. My favorite boxer, who would that be? Obviously, I was a huge Mike Tyson follower back in the days. But I really haven't been following boxing lately. Ever since the UFC came out, I've been an avid follower since day one. And the Conor McGregor situation, when he got into boxing, the one fight with Mayweather. Multi-million dollar deal. I like that, jumping from MMA to boxing. People do like the trash talking, and see if you can put your skills to the test. I think you did pretty well, in my opinion. And again, I'm not big on boxing, so people will probably argue otherwise. There's some more mansions over here. Check this one out. Can use a little renovating to bring it back to its glory. This one's pretty nice. Chicken barbecue. All right. Be honest, not much going on here in Canastota. Just a small little village, a couple of churches. You got your family-friendly pizzeria. What is this? We got a historic sign. Milton, home of Milton Deland, clerk of town of Old Lenox. Sheriff of Madison County. So this was the home of one of their famous individuals from back in the days, and now it's an American Legion. All right, let's cross. So I'm reading a website called niche.com, and they give reviews about different towns and so forth. This one guy writes, he gave it 3 out of 5 stars. Canastota is a close-knit community with great school districts, a district and multiple job opportunities. What I would like to see is improvement in tax rates. It is New York, and a decline in crime rate. So this person gave Canastota 4 out of 5 stars. The town itself is quaint and very community-oriented. Many people know the town members by name, and it's often you'll see a familiar face when going out to a local restaurant or grocery store. Most neighborhoods are well kept. I do suck in that. And communities are very friendly overall. The central school system is one of the largest flaws in this small town. So thumbs down for the school system. Let's see what else we can find. Canastota is mainly rural, though there isn't much in the town. The surrounding towns have much to offer in terms of food and entertainment. The neighbors are great and the air is clean, though it's often overlooked. There are amazing country views that offer peace and serenity. I would like to see the schools improve. So another person knocking down the school district here in Canastota. So yeah, a little taste from folks who actually live here. Well, I'm about to pick up my pizza. It's been 25 minutes, so they probably think I forgot all about it. The one thing we never do is forget about the pizza. All right, so we got the pie. We got the pie. Now we need a place to sit down and dig in. All right, we got New York pizza. Canastota, baby. Let's see how it looks. Looks awesome. Not gonna lie. Let's grab a small slice. This is looking good, baby. Nice and crispy, thin crust. All right, let's get messy, baby. Woo. That's what I call pizza. All right. I give it 7.8. It's good. It's good. There's part of the Erie Canal, and we just took a detour to check out some side streets. Unfortunately, it's a little dark, but there's a row of interesting looking houses here. Can't really see anything, but it's a barber shop. Erie Canal House. Kind of feels like a old school Western setup. These buildings almost kind of feel like movie sets, fake movie sets. You see in those old school cowboy movies. Looks like a tavern. ''1854 tavern. The street.